And the Polish man is 35 years of age now. And here comes Danny Williams, the Brixton bomber. Yeah, Danny now 40. Richie.
Steve, he seems to have been boxing for an age, doesn't he? Danny Williams had some great all-British showdowns for the Commonwealth and British titles with people like Julius Francis, Mark Potter, Sprott, Scott Gammer, Matt Skelton, Audley Harrison, Keith Long, John McDermott, Harry Senior, just to name a few.
But the problem I've got with Danny Williams, and I haven't really got a problem with Danny, but every time I see him, he's retired. And then 5 minutes later, he's fighting again.
Yeah. Just doesn't know when to stop, does he, Danny Williams?
No, he had that cracking fight in London with Dominic Negus. So here comes Danny Williams.
And
Dave Pereira in the corner.
And now, in the red corner, from Poland.
And Dave, if I remember right, is a former Fitzroy Lodge amateur. So coming to the ring now then, we have Marcin Rekowski. Don't forget, an undefeated fighter, 9 fights, 8 stoppage wins. 35 years of age now, Rekowski. And by the way, Rekowski's a substitute opponent. Williams should have fought a guy called Nori Seferi from Albania, but Seferi was actually hurt in training and sparring against this man, Marcin Rekowski. So they said, hey, you fight him. He said, okay.
Yeah, Rekowski looks decent, doesn't he? 8 of his 9 wins have come by KO. So he obviously can punch a little bit.
Yeah, but that doesn't say all, does it, Richie?
But at the end of the day, Steve, you've got to knock him out, haven't you? You know, he's knocked out what's been put in front of him, so he must have decent power.
Yeah, and I've got to say, Danny Williams looking so much better than he did when he fought Dominic Negus. Lost a lot of weight. Looks in good nick. So here comes Rekowski. He might look young, but he's 35 years of age now. He's on the wrong side, really, Rich, isn't he?
Yeah, he started boxing pretty late, hasn't he, at 35? But you know yourself, Steve, heavyweights go on a lot longer. He might do another 10 years yet, you know?
Very true. Well, I think Danny Williams will still be there in 10 years, won't he?
I certainly hope not.
This is a heavyweight contest scheduled for 8 rounds. And now, introducing first in the blue corner, with an amazing professional record of 44 wins, including 33 KOs and 17 defeats, official weight 128 kilograms, standing in at 1.91, coached by David Pereira, fighting out of London, UK, the Brixton Bomber, Danny!
And I'm very happy to call Danny an old friend.
Yeah, he's a great guy, Danny Williams. Lovely fella. Gentle giant, if anything.
And now, fighting out of the red corner, this man has a perfect professional record. 9 wins, 0 losses. 1.88 tall, official weight, 104 kilograms. The ring name is Rex, coach Rafał Kaluzny. From Poland, in the red corner, Marcin Rekowski. The referee in charge for this match is Mr. Holger Wiemann from Germany.
So here we go then, 8 rounds of heavyweight boxing in front of us. Danny Williams on the right against Marcin Rekowski. Now, interestingly, Rekowski there, the bigger man of the two, and yet he's 24 kilograms lighter, which isn't almost, well, in fact, it's over 50 pounds.
Indeed. I mean, this is a test and a step up for Rekowski. Although he's knocked out 8 of his 9 opponents, he's only actually fought 2 fighters with winning records, Steve. So this will be a big challenge for him.
Indeed it will. So Danny Williams in the black and gold. A practicing Muslim. And you don't get many boxers, Muslim boxers, do you, Richie?
You don't get many, to be quite honest, but I do know a couple. And very good ones as well.
Indeed. So Rykowski then from Poland, big lad, but giving away over 50 pounds here in weight.
Break, step back, okay? Box.
And Danny's still a very smart man. I remember Dominic Negus caught him with a lovely, lovely left hook and really rattled him. But Williams, you know, he kind of got over it. He took it, got over it, and came back.
Yeah, he knows. He's an old pro. He knows the game inside out. He knows his way around a boxing ring and how to avoid shots.
And Rykowski must realise he's in the deep end here.
And he will still carry that power, won't he, Williams? You know?
He still, yeah, he does.
That won't leave him, you see.
But what does go and does affect the power is, of course, the reflexes and the, you know, the eye-to-hand coordination. I mean, that's a problem, isn't it?
Yeah, big problem. Reflexes, most certainly.
Timing.
The biggest issue, Steve, is obviously the taking a shot, you know, the endurance and being able to take a punch.
And he still can take a good shot. I say, I saw him just a couple of months ago when he fought Dominic Negus, and he took some pretty lusty shots on that occasion. And Danny Williams, by the way, not licensed in Britain. He's got a license somewhere like Bratislava or somewhere, isn't it, Richie?
I don't know where it is, to be honest, Steve. But I've always considered Danny a friend, and to be honest, I don't want to see him go on too much longer in the game. I think he's had a great career, but there's a time to call it a day, and I don't think that's too far away now for Danny.
But as I said, Richie, he retires once a week.
Well, that's why, you know, he's not allowed to box back in the UK.
Oh, lovely right there. So the pole has success. And again, another good right. And there's the bell to end the first round, which must go, in my opinion, Rykowski's way.
Oh, no question yet, especially towards the end there.
So there's Rykowski in the corner, looking quite confident. Then a couple of thumping right hands towards the finish there. And, well, Danny Williams, well, he's got to get in there and get rid of this man, hasn't he, Richie?
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, Steve, I'd have seen a time when those punches would have just bounced off Danny Williams and had no effect whatsoever, but clear signs there that he's not the man he used to be. Danny Williams took a couple of good shots at the end there. His legs just wobbled slightly. And that's alarming for me to see, and that's why I don't want to see Danny Williams box on for too much longer.
And the first five fights of Rykowski, by the way, all ended within two rounds. More recently, they've been going longer. Now, whether he wants the rounds, I don't know. Or whether he's just been matched higher, I don't know. Anyway, round two of a scheduled eight-round heavyweight contest, and Rykowski in the blue. Marcin Rekowski has won the first round.
Don't hold the punch, okay? Don't hold the punch.
And Danny Williams does have a habit of getting close to you and putting his chest on yours. And it can be a bit ugly.
Well, obviously he's been told to keep that guard up a little bit higher. He got caught with a couple of right hands in that opening round, and that's mainly due to the fact that his left hand, his lead hand, was too low. And that's why he was open to that shot. But as he's coming forward now, his hands are a lot higher. He's trying to block that right hand punch. But Rykowski is trying to get through with that shot again. That's what his corner will have told him. Long range work behind your jab, straight right hand.
Well, he's not a bad lad, is he, Rykowski? I say, lad, he's 35 years of age. So Danny Williams then, former double British, double Commonwealth, former world title challenger. Shot. Good shot here now for Rakowski. And looks like Williams in big trouble now.
Yeah, got caught with the right hand, Steve. That started it all off, and now Rakowski's really going for it.
Stop. Let him go.
Well, Danny Williams has got over that. But good moments here for Marcin Rakowski.
You know what, Steve? I don't know whether he has got over it. I think, still think he looks a little bit unsteady on his legs, holding there on the inside, just trying to grab a few seconds. But for me, Rakowski here has got to go for it, and he is doing that.
Hurt him there, big left hook. Well, Danny Williams is clearly not the man he used to be. But, you know, he has the experience, Richie, to bring something out here.
I don't know, Steve. I think... I've said it all before, haven't I? I don't think you should go on much longer, and I think this is a clear indication of that. He's in against a novice here. He's getting caught with shots. He doesn't look right on his legs. And you can see why, back in the UK, they won't sanction him to box. Oh. Look at that. I mean, you know, the writing's on the wall here.
And having said that, Rakowski looks a bit robotic, but still lands another decent right. Yeah, I think Danny Williams is coming towards the end of his tether here. Lovely left hooks there. Oops, he's got him again. And Williams is all over the place here, but makes it through to the bell. Ooh, big round there for Rakowski.
Yeah, big round indeed, and probably a 10-8 round, if anything.
Yeah, but because he didn't hit the floor, Richie, you know, you've got to go with the referee. So he's only going to score that 10-9, isn't he? There's no official knockdown, but no. I know what you mean.
Yeah, a good round for the pole. Big shots going in. I thought he was going to finish him off here. Everything he threw seemed to hit the target. And Rakowski just keeping that gap as well, maintaining that gap so he can get his punches off and land the shots. But desperate situation here for Danny Williams. And like I say, he's a friend of mine. And at one point in his career, this fella wouldn't have lived with him.
Absolutely right.
Wouldn't have lived with him.
Well, he's a friend of everyone's, really, isn't he?
Yeah. But, you know, give credit to Rakowski. He can only try and beat what's put in front of him. And this fight's not over yet, but, well, I've said it, I think the writing's on the wall, and this is a good performance up to now from Rakowski.
Indeed. So here we go then, round three of a scheduled eight. And Marcin Rakowski in the blue shorts has hurt and rattled Danny Williams quite badly in round two. Referee telling Williams there not to hold. I can't say I blame him too much.
This is all or nothing now for Danny Williams. That's what he's decided, I think, anyway, in his own mind. He's going to try and knock this fella out.
Stop. Yeah, he's going to take him out of the game, isn't he?
Yeah, that's why he's going for it. It's an all or nothing situation.
And we don't know, of course, coming into this one, whether Rakowski, you know, is a lucky man to have got 9 straight wins. You know, he's been sensibly matched. Or is he a good fighter? I don't think we can say he's not a bad fighter, Richie.
Well, he's boxing very well up to now. He's got decent power. Yeah, look, Danny Williams, he's really going for it. He actually caught Rakowski there with a good left hook. And he knows he did also. And Rakowski there is just hanging on, but he got caught with a shot. That was a better shot from Danny Williams. He's just going for it. He's got the attitude now, I'm either going to knock this fella out or I'm going to get knocked out myself.
Absolutely. So we've got just about halfway to go in this round. And Danny needs to be throwing punches here to put Rakowski off.
Look how unsteady he looks, Steve, on his feet. Danny Williams. He's just got to try and hope to land that big right hand.
Well, you know what, Steve, if he lands it and he wins the fight, he probably thinks, you know, I can go on again and have a couple more contests. It's...
Yeah, that's the sad part, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very sad indeed. The last person to know when
he loses
is the boxer.
Yeah, even if he loses, he might say, I made a few mistakes, I'll get it right next time.
Yeah. But it's the chin, Steve, for me. He's getting caught with shots and the legs are going. And like I say, earlier on in his career, they'd just been bouncing off him. Look at this.
That was another hurtful left hook. And Danny, by the way, has worked on Eurosport with me a year or so ago. Yeah, he's still getting hurt here. Oh. And the referee could stop this one at any moment, and I wouldn't complain. There he goes, left hook.
Yeah, he's too brave for his own good, Danny Williams.
Is the referee going to give him a count? No. No, knockdown.
Box.
Well.
Time.
I thought the left hook went in there that put Danny on the floor, to be quite honest, Steve. It'd be great to have a look at the replay, see if the referee got it right or wrong there.
I thought a left hook put him over. Well, we've had three rounds, and I don't think Danny Williams has won a second of any of them.
He had a brief spell, didn't he, in this round where he looked to be going for it. And I think he made that decision in his mind, I've got to either knock this fella out, else it could be curtains for myself here, and went for it. But it was short and it was brief, and he couldn't quite land that big punch.
So here we go.
At some of the action.
There's that was it,
hook.
That was the shot.
Was that the one that put him down? That's the shot there. The referee was on the blind side of the referee. Have a look here.
Yeah, left hook.
Yeah. Short left hook, wasn't it?
Definite punch.
Seconds off, please.
So round four coming up of a scheduled eight. Yeah, Danny did have his moments at the beginning of round three. So Marcin Rykowski could be the real deal. But he's 35, so what future for him?
At times he looks a little bit tentative, Rykowski, and that's mainly because he knows he's up against someone who's very, very experienced, who is a big puncher, Danny Williams. He can hit and he's a lot heavier, and that's why I think Rykowski has chosen that tactic of just staying at bay, but he's catching Danny with these shots now.
Yes, a left hook clipped Williams a minute ago, and his left leg shuddered. Well, there's a sign that Williams is not enjoying this punching attention, trying to do everything he can to protect himself. Oh, big thumping left hook there again.
Oh, look at this, Steve. The referee should be stepping in here now.
Yeah, Danny Williams on the verge of defeat.
He's just going to get hurt here, Danny Williams.
And I don't want to see that, just like you don't.
No, I don't want to see it. You know, I know him personally, and he's always been a very brave kid. He's been a good fighter in his day, Danny Williams, but this clearly shows that he's at the end of the road. He's just trying to draw his opponent in because he's looking for one right hand to try and finish his opponent off. This is what he's trying to do here, drawing his opponent into this corner.
Let's face it, he can still find it, but got whacked again. And it's all over now, thank goodness for that.
Yeah.
So Danny Williams then stopped in four.
Well, I really do hope now, Steve, that Danny sees sense. He's had a great career. He's fought some great boxers. He's beat the great Mike Tyson. But I really believe now, and I hope rather, that he says enough is enough, and I'm going to call it a day.
Well, you know, he may announce his retirement after this particular fight, but you'll see him fight again another week or so.
I hope not, Steve, because it could really seriously affect his health, you see. And we've got to campaign, if you like, for boxers like Danny Williams, that they shouldn't be allowed to box on. This is why back in the UK, Danny's not allowed to box, because we don't think he should be, we don't think he's fit enough to box. But because we're trying to protect him, and that's what should happen here.
Yeah, protect him from himself.
Yes, definitely.
Yes, do you think that, like in America, they've got this national rule that goes around the place? Do you think there should be an international rule as well about if they're banned in one country, surely they should be banned in another?
Most certainly there should be a committee somewhere, shouldn't they, say, well, hold on, let's have a look. Let's have a look at this situation. And anyone who knows boxing knows that Danny Williams shouldn't be in the ring anymore.
Well, I'm not a big fan of the border control, as you know, but I think they were probably right in this case.
Well, certainly they were right, Steve. And I think other boards and other border controls around the world should take note. And as you say, if he's been banned by one board, then I think that should have a knock-on effect. And he shouldn't be allowed to box. And he's had a great career, Danny Williams, and
yeah,
he's been
much
a
as
good,
we love him.
Good fighter. He really
yeah,
is.
As much as we love him.
In the fourth round, is the red corner, Marcin Rekowski.
So Rekowski then declared the winner, a stoppage winner in four rounds over a sadly inadequate Danny Williams. Danny, knock it on the head. So here's the replay of the final moments there. All right, delayed reaction, certainly, but a hurtful one at that. Good win for Rekowski. 10 out of 10 for him now. And no one's gone the full route with him yet. Bad luck, Danny Williams. Well, still to come, we've got Christian Hammer against Leif Larsson. Now, you may remember...